The Railroad Time Capsule takes you back to the summer of 2007. It's very quiet here at Crescent, and you're not going to hear any train horns because there are no crossings at grade in this area, which means there are no auto versus train collisions. The Pennsylvania did it right. The four-track main line connected New York with St. Louis and Chicago. The line between Harrisburg and Pittsburgh tackles the Allegheny Mountains, so you'll see plenty of helpers and pushers. Well, that's always a good sign. This train is headed east toward Altoona and Philadelphia. Alright, I was wrong. The train blew its whistle, greeting a bunch of rail fans that have assembled. I was surprised by the number of excellent railroad viewing platforms along the way, accompanied by numerous railroad-themed bed and breakfasts and restaurants. Heading west toward Pittsburgh and points beyond. Thank you.
It's like a hopper train.
Another eastbound coal train. Thank you. We move from Crescent to Glitzen and the famous tunnels. Guess I saw the trains I was going to see in Crescent. And see any here spent about an hour. Across the tracks is a very nice bed and breakfast. This is the line looking east. And they also have a museum, which unfortunately was closed the day of my visit. Got really lost trying to find Horseshoe Curve. But that's okay, I'd been there a couple of times before. We headed back west through Crescent and just missed this train heading in the same direction. West of Crescent, we made this amazing discovery. This is Cassandra. I'm sure some of you know about this location, with its ex-highway bridge crossing over the tracks, which has been turned into a pedestrian bridge. Across the tracks is a nice park with a few picnic tables. Needless to say, you get an excellent view of the action below. Way in the distance, you can see another ridge of the Allegheny Mountains. A train heading west approaches. This one is headed east.
Time capsule land next? Why not subscribe and find out?